Dear students, welcome to my channel. In our data structure and algorithm tutorial, today we will learn the pop operation. Okay, so this is the implementation of stack. Basically, push and pop operations are two main aspects of stack. Push operation is basically used to insert an element into the stack, and pop operation is basically used to delete an element from the stack. Okay, in our previous tutorial, we have learned how to insert an element into the stack using push operation. Okay. So today we will learn the pop operation. Okay, that means to delete an element from the stack. So myself, Nilarji Shekhar Pal, I am working as an assistant professor at Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management at Computer Science and Engineering Department. Okay, so now come to the implementation of stack. Basically, pop can be implemented using array as well as linked list. Okay. If we want to implement the pop operation using static memory allocation, then we will use array. And if we want to implement it using dynamic memory allocation, then we will use linked list. What is static memory allocation? Static memory allocation is mean that all the memory, that is the element memory for the data elements, are occupied before the compilation. After compilation, no memory allocation is possible. But in case of dynamic memory allocation, memory is allocated for the elements or the data elements during the runtime. So you can insert extra elements, or you can insert unlimited elements in case of dynamic memory allocation. Okay. So in our next tutorial, we will learn linked list. Okay. So now we will learn the pop operation using the array. Okay, array is basically a collection of similar type of data elements. Okay, in array, all the elements are inserted. Okay, or all the elements are initialized, or memory is allocated before the compile time. After the compile time, we cannot able to insert any element. Okay. So this is the algorithm for pop operation. Okay, so you can see that this is the function main pop_stack. This is the stack, this is the top, and this is the item. These are all three the parameter list. Okay, stack is the list, top is the topmost element of the stack, and item which element we want to delete. Okay, in our previous lecture of push operation, we have seen when the stack is empty, then the value of top is -1. So when the value of top is -1, when there is no element into the stack, so delete operation or pop operation cannot be performed when the top is at -1 position. Top is -1 position is when there is no value or the no element into the stack. So if there is no element into the stack, we cannot delete any element, or we cannot perform the pop operation. So here is the condition: if top is -1, then we will print stack is empty or underflow condition, and we will return it. Okay. So if top is -1, no pop operation can be performed. So let's go to the example. Okay. After that, we will again discuss this algorithm. So this will perform the pop operation. Okay, suppose there is the 5 elements into the stack. Okay, 10 20 30 40 and 50, and this 0 2 0 1 2 3 4, these are the index value of the array. Okay, so as you can see, the value of top is now 4. Okay, so we can perform the pop operation. Okay, so always remember, in case of pop operation, always the top of the element of the stack will be deleted. We cannot perform the pop operation, or we cannot delete any element that is not in the topmost element. That is, we cannot able to delete 40, 30, 20 or 10 if we do not delete 50 at first. Okay. So if we delete 50, after that we can able to delete, or we can perform the pop operation on 40. Okay. So as you can see that we have performed the pop operation on 50. Okay. So now the top element is now at 3 position. Okay. So after performing the pop operation, okay, so the value of top is decremented by 1. So value of top is now top equal to top minus 1. Okay, so the value of top is now top equal to top minus 1. So the top value of top is now 3. Next, we will again perform the pop operation. As you can see that the element top of 3. Okay, so top is at position 3, the value is 40, we'll delete 40. Okay, so the value of top will be at 2. So top, the value of 3 minus 1, that is 2. Again we will perform the pop operation. So top is as now at position 2. So top become at number 1. After that, if we again perform, then the top will be at minus 1 position. Okay, so you can see that there is no element right now. Okay, the stack is empty now. So top is at minus 1 position, or we can see that this is an underflow condition. So can we be able to perform pop operation? The answer is no. Why? Because there is no such element in the stack. So why which element we will delete? So there is no element to delete in the stack. Okay, so I am again going to the algorithm. So this is the algorithm. So if top equal to minus 1, we cannot able to delete and perform the pop operation. We will print just stack is empty, or just print underflow condition, and we will return. Or if the top is not minus 1, then we will item, it will be stack of top. Okay, so which item will be deleted? The topmost element will be deleted, and the value of top will be top equal to top minus 1. Okay, so the value of top will be decremented by 1, and which element will be deleted? The item which is at the topmost element, that item will be deleted. Okay, so at last the exit. Okay, so I am just again doing the example. The top is at 4, so top will be now 3 as we perform pop operation. Next, top is at 3, we will perform pop operation, so top will be at position 2. Again, we will perform top operation, top is at 2, so top will be at 1 position. Next, again, we will perform the pop operation, top is at 0, so now the top is at minus 1 position. So, we are not able to delete any element from the stack as there is no element. So, this condition is called underflow condition. So, stack is empty now. So, student, this is the pop operation of stack. Okay. So, in our next example, we will discuss more about stack. Okay. So, if you have liked my tutorial, you can subscribe my channel. You will get a bell icon at your right hand side of screen. I am requesting you to subscribe my channel by clicking the icon. Okay, or you can visit www.facebook.com/jintelclassroom.milajipark and like my page to get all the notification about my tutorial. If you have any doubt, you can mail me at milajipark86@gmail.com. Okay, so student, thank you for this tutorial. In our next tutorial, we will see you once again. Thank you very much.